Hi, my name is Ian Van Tuyl, and behind me is a new listing of mine. It's a 1999 69-foot custom-built Philbrooks designed sailing yacht. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this magnificent vessel has to offer.
There are so many features that this yacht has to offer, but I want to start out and point out some of the ones as we go through it. We're going to notice this amazing anchor design here. We have a full custom stainless steel bow protectant that wraps around the forward section of the bow. We have a hydraulic Reckman furling system for the head sail, and we have a Harkin inner staysail. Also notice the attention to detail with all of the custom stainless steel work that's done on this yacht. A magnificent dark majestic blue hull with a gold cove stripe and a gold boot stripe. This Pilot House design yacht is absolutely spectacular. The quality and craftsmanship is just unbeat. It is very impressive. We have a really nice boarding ladder here that folds up and folds down, giving you great access into the vessel while underway. One of the really unique features about this yacht is the transom. Not only is it a great transom for boarding and coming in and off your dinghy, but the center transom completely lifts up and you have dinghy stowage with rollers right there, right here in the transom of the vessel. Very, very modern, really found on a lot of newer vessels of this size. So it's way above its time. But as you can see, we have nice stainless steel grab rails boarding the vessel. And then we also have our radar satellite arch here in the back. As we move up forward, you're gonna see hydraulic adjustable backstays, a large Harkin traveler. We have our spinnaker winches, our jib sheet winches are located up forward, and great ease of access into this yacht. I'm gonna take you up to the foredeck, but starting down below us is our shore power inlet that's hidden by this beautiful stainless steel cove trim. The windows themselves are completely surrounded in stainless, wrapped in here, a very seaworthy offshore yacht. And this was designed specifically for that. It is a full expedition yacht. As we move up forward, you're gonna see we have inboard shrouds here. This is all rod rigging. And then as we move up forward, you're gonna see just how amazing these cleats with rollers lead to here. So really great accessibility and a great design. As we walk up to the foredeck, we actually have a crew cabin access here along through the vessel, which I'll show you later. Our inner staysail with the Harkin furler. This is our windlass locker that you'll see from pictures. And as we move up forward, you can see the Reckman hydraulic furling system. Looking aft, it is quite spectacular, as you can see. We have a really nice stainless bar system here, two electric Harkin winches that operate the halyards and so forth. Everything is brought down here. We have two sheets leading into the cabin top, and that's the outhaul system for this yacht and the main sheet. So really well done. This is a beautiful hull spars mast, furling as you can see, triple spreaders, and again, something that's found on most 80-foot yachts. There's also a spinnaker pole up forward on this as well. Hydraulic vane, along with the hydraulic backstays that are controlled from the cockpit. As we move back aft, you're also gonna notice the handholds that are here, handholds and steps leading you up into the forward cockpit, and one level leading you all the way back to the transom. Enormous Harkin winches, 66.2s. This is the traveler winch. There are two very large storage lockers on both sides here. And again, the fit, the finish, the teak work, how it rolls up here, the stainless work with the continuous tow rail, it's absolutely magnificent. And there's that transom. Great access into it. Underneath these aft stern seats, we have stowage. There's a swim step shower. There's a deck washdown pump, a dedicated life raft locker. But really nice stern seats that have a really beautiful design, how they mold in to the forward facing helm seats. Here at the starboard helm, you're gonna see our VHF. We have a Robertson autopilot, the speed, the wind, the depth, and our rudder indicator. We also have controls over our head sail, our main sheet, our windlass, the transom garage door that lifts up with the push of a button, our bow thrusters. And what I love about it is everything is duplicated here on the port helm. We also have the hydraulic vane and backstay controllers here. Great access to our winches, electronic throttle control system, and again, everything is mimicked on this side. Centrally located is a beautiful teak table, very high varnished. It possesses lots of stowage, two big leaves that fold up so you can enjoy dining on both sides of the table. There's additional stowage that's found underneath these lazarette lockers. We have our compass, a multi-repeater, and then our controls for the winches. But as you can see, I mean, it is a remarkable design, way ahead of its time. The arch itself has the boom rest on it right here, but then you can see the main sheet leading aft to that very large traveler, and everything on this boat is push button. I'm gonna take you down below, but down below is quite unique. You have these beautiful opening teak doors here. As we come down below the vessel, you're gonna see the pilot house station that's located here. Again, every detail from the handholds here, leading you nice, gentle, gradual steps into the vessel itself. We're at our lower nav station where we have our electrical panels. We also have our generator controls, main engine controls located here. We have our electrical panels and then our really nice helm seat. We also have a third engine control from down here, our instrumentation, our engine readout, and our Robertson autopilot and rudder indicator. Bow thruster controls down here as well. So when you're sitting in this seat, you have phenomenal visibility from this pilot house. So directly across from the nav station is this really nice table here with double seats. We also have a nice dedicated area for all of our burgees. We have our stereo control, VHF control here. And again, the attention to detail, the fit, the finish of all of the woodwork, the cabinetry is spectacular. Centrally located overhead is a speed, wind, and depth repeaters. And then I'm gonna take you forward into the salon of the vessel. And as you can see here, this is quite spectacular. This could be totally modified, but it is a really unique design with four seats around this table. We have a nice library section over there. Centrally located is our television, real high-end stainless steel hood opening hatches, lots of hatches, lots of great ventilation, but a remarkable salon table here with pivoting seats that also have a reclining action in them as well too. So really neat design and spectacular. Directly across that is our galley. Our galley possesses an amazing amount of storage. We have a Miele dishwasher, three burner stove and oven, a microwave, big double stainless steel sinks with a center sink here with a garbage disposal built into it. We have the hot water system, our hot and cold water system located here. As you can see, coffee cup holders, everything on this yacht has a place. So from our glasses to our wine glasses, spice racks, our dishes, down below here, amazing amount of drawers and stowage. But you can see there's even cutouts for all of the pots and pans, and it's just really well thought out and really taken to the next step. Tons of cabinetry stowage here, and this massive Samsung freezer and refrigerator. We also have water and ice located here in the door. As we keep on moving forward, we're gonna go to the forward cabin, which has split double berths and then access into our crew cabin. We have additional pantry stowage here. And then this is our washer and dryer. So we have a really nice high-end Miele washer and dryer here. Okay, walking up to the forward stateroom, you can see how they have it's split here. Amazing amounts of stowage and hanging locker space. behind that. We also have a heating system as well too. And beautiful up here. I mean, it's just absolutely gorgeous. So we have its own private head and shower, vacuum flush toilets, a full walk-in shower with beautiful stonework. Really nice opening hatch here as well. But you know, the stonework itself is just gorgeous. Really nice high-end fixtures. And then you can see the footprint of the shower. It is quite large, with this oval shaped door, just giving you an additional space. Beautiful Corian countertops here. Again, high-end fixtures and faucets found throughout, and the attention to detail on the woodwork and the flooring is absolutely spectacular. So two really nice Seabirds here. I suppose if you wanted to, you can do a filler cushion and make this one large VIP suite too, if you so desire. And then through this door, you have access into our crew cabin. It possesses a manual toilet. We have a sink up here, lots of stowage. We have our cockpit cushion stowed up here. Forward is our windlass anchor locker. Lots of shelving throughout, and a massive overhead opening hatch. So I'm gonna take you back aft through the yacht. This is another attention detail I just want to point out. Look at the louvering in the door. I mean, everything that you look at is just spectacular. I mean, you can see while, you know, this vessel new was about, you know, $3.5 million. One thing that I want to point out to you here is this really beautiful aft wall. And let me show you here with the push of a button that's located just right here at fingertips reach. We're going to open this up, and this gives us access to our engine room. All right, you can see the depth of the sound shield, how amazing this all is. I mean, we have full engine access down here. Generator controls, we have start and stop for the engine. The generator itself has 244 engine hours. The engine itself has 606. 0.8 engine hours. Very, very lightly used. The generator is brand new. And as we walk in, we can see we have the sea recovery water maker system here with all of its filters. All of the hydraulic controls are led back through here with through all of the relays and what have you. Our generator, Raycore filter, our exhaust system here. This is our man diesel engine that powers the yacht. And then we also have the hydraulic drive that powers all the hydraulic systems. There's a shaft leading out with a shaft brake as well. So all of these systems that are found on this yacht is stuff that they're doing today on a lot of the modern yachts. Just aft is a massive water pump. We have the engine dual Raycore filter system there. We have the battery charger, Xantrax 1000 watt inverter, and ProSign charger as well. But fabulous engine room. You have also access above as well too, but I just wanted to show you this trick point right through this engine room. Okay, moving back through the pilot house, going aft into the master stateroom. Now, I've been on lots of yachts, but this master stateroom for a vessel of this size is truly spectacular. You can see this king size centerline berth. Lots of stowage underneath the bed. We have full hanging locker closet, stowage galore. And again, the woodwork, the attention to detail here is spectacular. We have a bookshelf through here, but look at the woodwork and what they've done over the bed. I mean, it's just fabulous what they've incorporated on this yacht. Looking forward, we have access to our TV, additional shelving, additional hanging locker closets over there. There's another library behind this door that has a lock. All the doors have really nice bronze locks on them, along with all of the handles found throughout. But this is Tango. So this is what Tango looks like. This is its keel design. This is the shaft, the propeller, the rudder system on it. But this is one spectacular yacht, and very, very impressive. Just forward of that, we have a full length mirror here. We have our vacuum flush toilet, large countertop sink, medicine cabinet there. this door opens up and you have access to this full walk-in shower. Again, the stonework that was used is just absolutely gorgeous. Here's another perspective of looking at the aft master. Plenty of headroom. We even have really nice grab handles overhead, opening hatch overboard. We have deck prisms that let the light in. So just again, well thought out. Over off to the starboard side is a desk vanity. We have a computer monitor here, the controls for the PureSign inverter, and then other communication systems found throughout. We'll have also diesel heating system as well. I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you'd like more information in regards to this custom-built 69-foot Philbrooks designed yacht, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.